everyone. Welcome to our April 2018 Phoenix Tableau user group. We always like to start, raise your hand if this is your first time. What do we think that is, guys? A third, a half, 40%, 50%? Okay. Well, welcome. Actually, you know what? I want to stop you guys and ask. For those of you that are new, what was your reason for showing up today? I need a reason. It's 6 o'clock on a Thursday night. You were at work all day. Why are you here? Go ahead. Excellent answer. I want two more answers.
I had an invite from a coworker and I'm very interested.
Okay. I'm looking at you.
I want to learn more about Tableau as well.
You want to learn more. So does that mean something got you excited about it? Yeah, go ahead.
I'm using it right now, but it's struggling a little bit. So.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So struggling a little bit. Want to learn more.
I'm an R user, but I know data visualization is really important.
Got it.
I want to increase the skills.
So, yeah, go ahead.
I'll clarify my answer a little bit.
Yes.
I work at Stokes Equipment, formerly known as Arizona Machinery.
Okay.
They're a John Deere equipment dealer. They have 25 locations across the Midwest. I'm the only business analyst for that entire company.
How is that possible? You are a god, sir.
I've only been there 4 months. I need to pick up the speed and get up to speed.
Well, you are in the right place. I think you made a wise decision spending your after hours here. So welcome. Anyone else new that wants to share why they've decided to come here on a Thursday? Anyone who's come here on a Thursday frequently want to share why they keep coming back? Yeah, go ahead.
I've been bragging to a couple of coworkers because they noticed that my Tableau skills have picked up.
Yeah, you're a baller now? Yeah.
Yeah, so they've given me recognition, so I invited a few of them, but I don't see them here today.
Shade, we'll throw shade at them. No shade, always welcoming, always room for more. We've got empty seats, there's always an opportunity. Anyone else? All right, well, thank you guys for sharing. I don't think we usually do that, but you know, we've noticed kind of a pattern that there's a lot of enthusiasm, a lot of energy, not a lot of new people coming, so it's always really interesting for us to hear the why behind why you showed up. And then for those of you who don't raise your hand because you're back, we love that, right? We want to know why you keep coming. So I appreciate both ends of that. Before we kind of dive into things, let me get this to go to the next slide. Maybe. Here's who we are. I haven't introduced myself, so my name is Ann Jackson. I am a Tableau Zen Master, currently a solution architect for Slalom Consulting, which is a local consulting firm. What you're seeing is our leadership council. We call it the TLC, which is very affectionately named. To my left here, we have Michael Perillo, who's down here, and then a couple other leadership folks in the audience. Justin, would you stand up or wave or do something fantastic? Yes. You'll be hearing from him later. And then Josh, who randomly enough has the same last name as me because he's my husband, is also in the audience and one of our leadership members. Layla, who is also a Tableau Zen Master, which is denoted by this little guy here, it's her birthday week, so she selfishly did not want to be here on a Thursday night after work, and I don't blame her. And then Jeff is not with us tonight because he is visiting family back in Virginia, I believe, at this time. Or he's in Korea. It's one of the two. I can't remember which one.
I think it's the Korea one.
I think it's the Korea one now that I've said it out loud. So the point of this is these are our friendly faces. If you have questions, you're getting started with Tableau, we are your number one resource. There's six of us for a reason. There's four of us here, and that's so that we can try to answer any questions you have, be a guiding light for you. So if someone monopolizes Michael's time and you need to come to me as a backup, please feel free to do that. If you see one of us and we're not talking, that's your opportunity. That's an open invitation to come bother us. We love nothing more than to talk about Tableau all the time. It's 6 o'clock, I'm drinking coffee, I'm ready to talk about Tableau. I think you guys would say the same things. Yeah. Oh, look, Justin's got his coffee too. So we're all in alignment there.
If we're talking amongst each other, we're just talking about Tableau. So
So if you want to eavesdrop on our conversation just to learn more, to learn about what it is that we talk about, more than happy to have you be a fly on the wall. So we always like to talk about resources, things out there beyond the user group. So things that you can look out for on the internet just to get smarter about it. There's two things we're just going to talk about, which is Think Data Thursday. There's a link for you. So if you want an opportunity to think about Tableau once a week, go to Think Data Thursday, and then Tableau Talk Data to Me is an ongoing series to learn a little bit more about this. What else do we have? Present or sign up. Oh, I love this. I love how sad this looks. So we're here, right? April's blocked out, which means we filled this time. We've got May filled out. We've got June and July, which means I would love for someone to fill in August, September, October. Please. The way we format this, for those of you that are new, is we try to break it up this two-hour segment into two sections, almost like two 40-minute sections with like about, 10, 15 minutes for you guys to stretch your legs, do networking, get really excited, ask us questions. In between, you'll see that unfold tonight. But what we really need are you guys out in the audience to say, hey, I have an interesting topic to talk about. It can be work-related, it can be non-work-related. So that's all this is we have a sign-up sheet. Michael, I'll hold it up. We have a sign-up sheet. It needs some names on it. It needs people to sign up. If we talk to you and you have an interesting story, we're gonna beg you to sign up. And that just makes it so that other people, you guys, are talking. You're not hearing my annoying voice every month. And you guys get an opportunity to grow as a result, look like a baller, back at your organization, do whatever you want to do. And I would say particularly, so two things here. One, if you're thinking about presenting at the Tableau Conference in 2018, they've extended speaker submissions to April 22nd, and a user group is a great dress rehearsal for that. So if you are a customer of Tableau and you would like to get a free ticket to TC18, which is in New Orleans, and you have a compelling user story, I encourage you to submit an application that will get you into the conference for free. They do cool banquet stuff for the speakers. You're treated like a celebrity. It's truly a great conference. And then I would encourage you to use this platform as a dress rehearsal for that that presentation. So come sign up in between on the break. Next month, so monthly meetings on the third Thursday of each month, which is awesome. So the next third Thursday is May 17th. The two topics we'll be discussing are data profiling and data prep. You're gonna get a little bit of that sense today when Justin talks during the second half. And then we're also gonna be doing Workout Wednesday. You're gonna see what that is today. Michael's gonna kind of unpack that topic a little bit further. So you'll see that. We do that pretty much every month. That's just a hands-on opportunity for you guys to see what the tool looks like if you're new, test your skills if you're more seasoned, that kind of thing. And I think that's pretty much it for the pre stuff.
Yeah, so the first, we'll jump into Workout Wednesday in just a moment. I'll cover what that is. The second half today, we're going to go over Tableau's pre-release beta program. So if you're a customer, this is something that you could and should participate in. And Justin's going to really talk to you a lot about what that is. So Tableau's got a lot of really cool products that are up and coming in the future. So we want you to know what's out there. We want you to get your hands on it, play with it, give them feedback, and start propelling what does that look like for the future, and bring that into your organization.
All right, any questions or thoughts before we get started? Yeah. Oh yes, let me go back. That's very important. And that's a good opportunity. So for those of you that are new and you have your laptop and you have a copy of Tableau or Tableau Public, if you want to get that up now, part of what this Workout Wednesday is it can be sort of a follow along process if you want it to be. So that's a good opportunity. And of course, you'll probably need Wi-Fi to do that.
So those of you that are new or have been coming a while, bring your laptop. I'm not gonna stress that enough. Next month, bring your laptop. The month after that, bring your laptop. The reason why, we're always gonna have some kind of hands-on activity, and the best way to get good at Tableau is to actually play with it. We've also got six resources. Three today, four today. But if you got a problem with business, or you're learning, or you just wanted us to look over your shoulder and do something, there's an opportunity for that, but we can't help you unless you got a laptop. So bring a laptop. Any other questions? And then if not, we'll get started. All right, let's get started. Now those of you with a laptop, do you all have Tableau installed, whether it's Tableau Desktop or Tableau Public? Good to go?
Desktop.
Desktop.
All right. So, we're going to go through and just do a quick primer because it seems like we do have quite a number of new users in here, and it's always good to do a refresher on kind of the Tableau environment. So we've got Ann, Josh, and Justin. For those of you that are going to follow along on the Workout Wednesday as we go through this, if you need help, they'll be right here helping you out. So don't be afraid, raise your hand, or this is an opportunity to be engaged. Ask questions. All right, so this is the Tableau workspace. You got Tableau installed, you boot this up. This is initially what you're gonna see, and it's good to have the vocabulary down, the vernacular on what is the toolbar, where's the data pane, where's the analytics pane, where's the view, where are the cards, what's the shelf, those types of things. So we really want you to make sure that you understand, you know, this is Tableau Desktop, and we're gonna start to use a lot of terminology, and the best way to follow along is to kind of understand what is the tool that you're working with, right? So we see up in the left-hand corner, that's the workbook name. All right. Pretty simple. What we're, do you have a pointer?
In my bag, maybe.
Or these are by letter, if you can see them. So letter E is the go to start page. When you launch Tableau Desktop, you're initially presented with a little bit different screen. It allows you to connect to data, kind of look at where? Look at that. Thank you. Go to blogs, go to the forums.
On the side.
There we go. Alright. No laser?
No, it should work.
Battery. It's all right. We'll go with the letters. Got it?
Awesome.
Thank you. All right. So that's the go to start page. This is nice because you can actually click and toggle that back and forth. So it's a nice way to go to the visualization that you're either creating or go back if you need to edit your data sources or you want to see what else is there. This is also going to show you where your last 6, 10, 12, whatever workbooks that you have created in the past are going to be there, an opportunity for you to pin it. So think about like your browser, right? It's going to show you your most recently visited things, or in this case, Tableau's, what did I last create, what I've been working on, a way for you to kind of pin things in there or not. Again, going quickly, this is the toolbar. Toolbar has a ton of stuff on it. We're not going to cover it, because guess what? In Tableau Desktop is a help file. In the help file, there's a nice page that has all the visual cues, and each one of these is up there, and it tells you exactly what it does. You can also hover over each of those buttons, and it tells you exactly what they do with a shortcut key command if you want to be really cool with Tableau, using the keyboard for fast access. This centerpiece right here, where we're always going to kind of create your visualizations, this is your view area. And then the sidebar. So the sidebar consists of your data pane, your analytics pane, your dimensions, and your measures. And then over here, if you have any sets, parameters, those things will be listed down there. So again, in your help file, this is where this is pulled from. So there's no reason for you not to learn a little bit of, again, your workspace environment, the vocabulary, the visual cues. Takes just a few minutes just to kind of go over that. Now to kind of jump into the view area, again, this is where we're really gonna create the visualization, and I'm gonna talk to a lot of these names here as we start the Workout Wednesday. So let's make sure that we're comfortable with that. Up here again, we have a title. The title doesn't always have to be displayed or will be displayed on your view, but we're gonna show you how to kind of toggle that on and off. The marks. Marks are essentially what you're seeing. So those could be dots, those could be bars, those could be lines. Those are essentially your chart type. It depends on how you bring over that data, depends on how many marks are on your view area. The more marks that you have, performance could be impacted in Tableau. Again, a lot of stuff thrown at you. For those of you that are new, don't worry about it. It's, again, just terminology. Up here in A, these are your field levels. E, this is kind of your axis. Axis, X and Y. Y is up and down. X is going across. These are headers. Headers could be down at the bottom. They could be on the side. They could be on the top. But they're the ones that are really going to kind of designate what is that dimension, that field level. Over here, we've got a legend. We're going to actually be working with a legend today, customizing that. So that's pretty much it as far as the vocabulary, the interface. So let's kind of talk about what is Workout Wednesday. So Workout Wednesday is a weekly social experiment, kind of much like its counterpart, Makeover Monday, where Workout Wednesday is a little bit different. It really emphasizes skill building. So having you go through and assess, in this case, a visualization, and you're trying to recreate that. The visualization that we're going to look at today might seem pretty straightforward, but we'll get into kind of the meat of it. The good thing about this is you can download this stuff off of Tableau Public, off the website Workout Wednesday. We got the link on there. And you can go through and start reverse engineering things to see how things are built. But the whole goal along the way of this is to really help you learn new skills. And in this case, what we're going to talk to, this is not PowerPoint, so click over. So again, the idea is to replicate this pretty much like for like, as opposed to the other counterpart, Makeover Monday, where it's to totally reimagine it with storytelling and creativity. This is functionality. This is formatting. This is kind of the logistics around how do I get that to work? And that's what we're going to work on today.
Ooh, and I will interject that I am one of the Workout Wednesday coaches now, so I am responsible for I think it's every third week now to give you guys an extreme workout. So it would be an honor to see some of you guys use that as a tool to flex your skills to problem solve in Tableau. Something very special to my heart. It's how I got really good at the tool as well. Makeover Monday and companionship with Workout Wednesday. I love it because there's an end goal. You know what you're trying to build. So if you're struggling and you're trying to get to the next level, you see cool things, it's a great opportunity to problem solve. And again, like Michael said, the solution's there. Go look at the solution. If you're too lazy to build it yourself, just go see the cool solution and then reverse engineer from there.
Yeah. And what are we, 2 years in now?
Yes, pretty much. Yes. Yeah,
so there's a lot of stuff to go out, download. It goes from pretty basic to pretty damn crazy. Yeah. So download a lot of that stuff, and again, reverse engineering is always kind of a good way to learn, figure it out. This one is really geared, I think, more towards kind of beginner, maybe some pieces of intermediate, but for everyone that does have a laptop, I want to make sure that you're all on board with this. So today's workout is week 6 of this year, 2018, and we're really leveraging our formatting skills and our knowledge of formatting colors, hierarchies, in the sense of creating a product hierarchy, which we're going to do in just a moment. And then that's about it. So again, it's really putting all these pieces together. Everyone's got their own style, and what I do isn't necessarily the right way or the only way, it's just a way. So you can do a lot of things in Tableau, 100 different ways, so if you find a different way, a different tip, trick, do it, that's fine. As long as you kind of end up in the same result, you're good to go. So again, for those of you that want to participate, you can go to the Workout Wednesday website, workout-wednesday.com, or I've got a little shortcut bit.ly link here that'll take you directly there. I'll leave that open just for a moment, and then we'll kind of move on.
How many of you guys are going to try this?
Everybody that I passed out a paper should be raising their hand.
Good. Yeah.
And if you don't have a laptop,
it's a really
buddy.
Short arms.
So we're going to be using the sample superstore that's built into it. So if you want to go ahead and get connected to that, do that. If you need help launching Tableau or getting connected to the sample superstore database, go ahead and raise your hand. We'll kind of walk through and help you do that. All right. So for those of you that I passed around the data sheet, you can follow along. If you have the laptop, Wi-Fi access, and you're on the Workout Wednesday website, the requirements are pretty much right there. We'll go through those in just a moment, but we're really only going to pick, I believe, five fields. This is here somewhere. So we're going to be using today category, subcategory, region, sales, and segment. What I will recommend is once we're done with that, as far as best practice goes in Tableau land, we're going to hide all the other unused fields. And that's more just as a best practice going forward for you to get used to. If I don't need the data, hide it so I'm not sharing the rest of that information and hitting a performance load on my server or Tableau Public. If the data's not needed, no reason to bring it in. Does that make sense? All right, so again, let's kind of look at this. So the dashboard requirements, we're gonna make this 600 by 800. We're gonna create a product hierarchy out of category and subcategory. We're gonna do some sorting. We're gonna do some cool stuff with colors. We're gonna do crazy stuff with lines and grid lines and min lines and max lines, all that cool stuff. And then we're gonna use one of the fields as a filter. So the first thing, as you go through and you connect to your sample superstore data, we're going to need to create a worksheet. Okay. After you create a worksheet, there's nothing on it at this point. What you want to do is create a dashboard. The dashboard is indicated by, let me get out of full screen there. Probably can't see it over here, but it's a little grid-like. It's going to be your center icon down at the bottom, depending on how you have your setup, if you're showing the thumbnails or not.
Anyone need help?
That's on his desktop.
And the reason why we're creating these now, again, is best practice. So the worksheet, go ahead and give it a name. I think on mine, called mine regional sales. You can give yours any other name. The reason why I tell you to do this up front is because I don't want you to get in the habit of using the default sheet one. And then when you're done, you publish it and you've got a dashboard called dashboard one. It means nothing to anyone, especially for your data governance and server people. It's frustrating. The people that search for your workbook, they have no idea what that means. So give it a friendly name. We're going to start off with best practice right off the bat. So we're naming your workbook, something like regional sales, sales, whatever you want, and then the dashboard, something similar. This is very much like Excel. So for those of you that, again, that are working in Tableau, it's just double click on the sheet and give it a nice friendly name. So we're going to knock off setting the dashboard size right away. So if I was doing this, again, from scratch, I've got a dashboard up. So I've got the option right here to change the size. And I mentioned, explore what the options are down below. You know, these are not going to give you anything, the 600 by 800 out of the box. So you do have to go in and select the custom format for your width. that's gonna be the 600. And your height is 800. Pretty simple, right? So go ahead and check that off. You've got one of those requirements done. All right, any questions about that? Pretty straightforward. Anyone need help? And again,
that's the file that comes with Tableau, right? The sample superstore?
Correct, the sample superstore database.
All right, where would I find it?
So if you got, you're on the data page, or page that's already preloaded, it's usually at the bottom, the sample superstore, got a pre-built in there. If not, you can go into the My Repository, My Tableau Repository, in your documents folder under data sources, and you should have the Excel file or TDE file, sample superstore. All right, the next thing that we're gonna do, once you're connected to Sample Superstore, we're gonna go back to your worksheet. And you should see something similar where it's got all your dimensions and measures on there. We're gonna build out the product hierarchy using category and subcategory. And again, there's a couple different ways to create hierarchies. I'm going to show you the way that I do that. All right. So this is a big list, and I'm not going to go through and start looking in the different folders for where the product category, subcategories. So I'm actually just using the search box. Which is here somewhere. And I'm starting to type category. So this is way it's gonna filter exactly category and subcategory right off the bat. Again, you don't have to do it this way. There's tons of other ways to do it. So I did a control click, and if you're using Mac, command or option click or something, it works.
Switch to PC.
Get a Windows machine.
Yeah.
No. But highlighting both of these, we'll do that. Again, you can do it manually. You can kind of create the hierarchy first and drag and drop the field in there. If by accident you move other fields in there, you can also move them out. So it's very flexible. So right now I've got category, subcategory highlighted. So I'm going to right click and I'm going down the hierarchy. You already got this created, I assume. And she already had this, or I already had this created, but ultimately I would have had create hierarchy, and I would have given it a nice friendly name, and in this case I named it product hierarchy. So now, instead of two distinct fields kind of just living in your data set, you've got this product hierarchy that you can expand, and now you see category and subcategory. Depending on how you did this, your subcategory may present itself first at the top, depending on how you clicked. If it is, you can just drag that below, and now it's ordered, again, category, subcategory. Sound good? All right. So we've got two things checked off. So now we need to right align each member of the hierarchy. In order to actually do that, we need to take that product hierarchy that we just created, and we're going to drag that up into the column shelf at some point. Sorry, row shelf. So again, if you named yours product hierarchy, that's fine. Once you drag that over onto the shelf, it's actually gonna give it the name category. And then when you expand that subcategory. So you're not going to see that nice friendly name, product hierarchy. Does that make sense to everybody? All right. So we're going to need to right align these columns here. So let's go ahead and we'll jump into Tableau and we'll do that. So formatting, this is where formatting comes in. And it should be pretty straightforward, but right clicking on the field is gonna expand that for you. Let's just go to format.
Excuse me, I'm sorry.
Yep.
I forgot your name.
Michael.
Michael. I have the category up in my rows shelf, but how did you pop out the subcategory?
So if you created the hierarchy,
yeah,
to where you can expand it and you see category, subcategory under it, you did that right. If depending on what you named your hierarchy, you need to drag that over to rows. If you just dragged category there, it's not going to give you the full
thing. So I clicked on the plus button.
So you got both of these now, right?
Yeah.
Everybody good?
I see some people already done. You guys are killing it back here. I know.
They should be up here. All right.
You're doing great.
All right. Well, we'll move a little quicker. So we need to right click on the pill, and we're going to go to format. Under alignment, under the default, we're just going to use the right alignment for instead of automatic. This is under horizontal. Again, I will be critical. I don't care. I hate formatting. I hate the way Tableau does things. I think they could improve upon that. And that's on video. I don't care. It's horrible. So, you know, trying to figure out what the lines are and the rows, the grids, the paint, it's, even after 5 years, it's still frustrating. So, it may take time. It's all right. So, we can easily just click on subcategory now. We don't have to go back into right-clicking and format. The pane's already open. So, we go over here and choose the left alignment there. And we saw it move. So, it was automatic, and now both pills are right-aligned. If we collapse this, guess what? It's still right aligned. If we expand it, it's still right aligned. So we've got essentially another option checked off, right?
Format.
Okay. So let's get out of formatting. Now we need to. We're going to sort by the sum of sales. So we've got sales under here, and there's, again, a few different ways that we could do this. We can go in and start double-clicking up in here, and we can do an inline typing of this calculation, sum of sales. Sales is an actual field. What we want to do is kind of aggregate this, so we need to do a sum of sales across these different product lines. As a new user or just someone that, again, wants to do kind of best practice, to understand the data, I'm actually going to create a calculated field. So I'm going to right-click on sales. I'm going to go to create, and I'm going to choose calculated field. And I'm going to call this total sales. You can call it whatever you want. The expression, again, is just sum of sales. And
I think you've got a duplicate field name.
I do. I've already done this.
Yes.
Because I was that good. We'll call it sum of sales one, just so it's good. Once it's good, down in the bottom, you're going to get a calculation is valid if there's any errors, or as Ann said, I've already got something called total sales. So it says, hey, something's wrong. It'll show up red. I couldn't figure that out. I did this already. So we're good to go. All right, so let's click OK. Again, total sales I've already got. They're the exact same thing. I'm going to drag that up into my columns. And that gives me a really cool bar chart. So again, Tableau is going to do a lot of things by default. When you drag something over, or you drag multiple fields, or click on multiple fields and go to your Show Me, it's going to show you a lot of what Tableau can do out of the box. It recommends that says, hey, based on what you've just selected, we think bar charts is the best way to visualize this. So that's why we're getting this bar chart. If we selected some other things, it may present a little bit different type of chart for us. Does that make sense to everybody? Yes.
Was the calculated field just so you could have a better name for it?
So I could have came in here and I could have manually typed in sum of sales. And because I'm not technically reusing it in other worksheets or dashboards, it's kind of a one-off thing. But again, for kind of best practice for me, I want that in my deck, you know, under my measures, so I can see total sales, so I know. But again, you could do it a bunch of different ways. Well, really two ways.
Yeah, I would say you can, I think what you're describing is, can you just drag on that and then set the measure for, you know, to aggregate, to do that aggregation, absolutely.
Yeah. So yeah, in essence, I could come over here, drag that, and do that aggregation level up to the sum level. So I could have done that too. So we saw in the very beginning that we're kind of creating this little barbell chart type thing. That's not a out of the box visualization. What this is really two of the same charts, just different uses of the visuals. So we're gonna see that right now. So the way to kind of duplicate this same exact chart, the easiest way is to do a control click. Now I can come back here and I can bring total sales up to again, but just know this is a nice quick shortcut. Holding down the control key, dragging this over adjacently and dropping it in gives us two of the same charts, exactly the same. All right? I know, mind blown, right? So let's do that again. So the other way I could do that, I can pull total sales up here and just drag it over. But again, as you get more proficient with Tableau and that extra millisecond that it's gonna take you to drag something over, you can just quickly control click and then drop it right next to it. And that's essentially copy, right? Control C is copy, control. So Tableau's got a lot of that native Windows stuff. Maybe Mac stuff too, if you know. All right, so we get here. We've got two identical chart types. Now it's saying, hey, go ahead and sort these hierarchies descending by your sum of sales, total sales, whatever you've got. So we're gonna come up here under this category, and we're gonna choose sort. And again, this says do it descending by the sum of sales. In this case, I called mine total sales. And I'm going to hit OK. And I'm going to do the same thing for subcategory. So I'm doing descending by the field type, which is total sales. And again, yours may be different. You may have opted for that sum of sales. So just choose accordingly. All right. So we've got, looks like, four things knocked off our plate. Next one is match color on region using a cool palette color. Before we do that, because I need to kind of start to see what I'm actually working with, we know that we have circles and we know that we have some kind of a line. So let's go ahead and knock that out right now. I'm going to take that first aggregated total sales under the marks area. Be sure you're not under all. So right now we've got three sections here. The all kind of is all encompassing. The one below it is your first total sales. The second one over here has to do with essentially this chart.
Which one did you start?
It actually really doesn't matter. So are you kind of at this point here where you've got two identical chart types?
Yeah, but she's not getting the sort, right?
Oh, the sort? So we need to do by descending. So let's go on category. You need to make sure it's on descending, and then the field needs to be either sum of sales or total sales or whatever you've got that you created that calculated field.
So what's the fucking sort?
Justin, can you help? So the sort just needs to be made sure that you're on descending, and then under field for the sort by, do you have, you got it? And then do the same thing for subcategory. Make sure that that's identical on the descending, and then your sort by is total sales or sum of sales or whatever you've got there. And then as you start to look at the category and subcategory, really it's kind of a reverse alphabetical order for the most part. But it's by the price. So, all right, so what was I saying? So we're gonna go in, actually change this first chart type. Let's change it to the circle. Okay. Now, we're gonna kind of knock this all out in one shot. So we know that we need to assign region as a color on this. So let's go find region. Again, I am not gonna go through the whole list. I see it right there, but I like to use the search. There's region. I'm gonna drag this and drop it right onto the color mark card there. And that gives me my nice little color scheme. We do need to put a little border around this, as I saw in the picture here. So we're gonna click on the color again. Under the effects, under border, instead of automatic, let's go ahead and give it a little black border. And I think we're good there for now. Now let's go ahead and change this other visualization from the bars. We could leave it bars and we can kind of adjust it and, you know, give it a black color and size it, but I'm all about a line right now. I think line's gonna be the easiest thing to do. We're gonna color that black because it told us to. We want to make it super thin. Now this kind of looks off, right? We're not getting that horizontal. So the reason why we're not getting that yet is we actually need to drag the region over to the path. All right? So now we've got the dots and we've got the line. Is everybody good here? All right. So now we've got two identical charts. What we want to do is kind of overlay these on top of each other. So we're going to click on really doesn't matter, the second total sales, the aggregate there. We're going to come down and we're going to choose this dual axis. And now we've got them sitting on each other. I don't know if you can notice, but my line is actually kind of jumped on top of my circles. So all that's telling me is that when I ordered these, I kind of did them in reverse. So I'm going to take this first total sales and I'm going to drag it to the right. Or I could have dragged the other one to the left. It really didn't matter. Does that make sense? So now it's kind of ordering it by whatever the visualization is. So my circles are now on top. The nice cool line is on the back. Does everybody kind of have a chart that's starting to look like this? No? No. Almost close?
I didn't get the color right.
So we're not on the color yet. So we're going to do the color. We're going to do the color now. If you're not on the website and actually looking at the color, this is super hard to kind of discern. So I'm going to help out. Let's go over here and we're going to look. And I apologize, this is going a little slow in this story mode. All right, so we already set the lines. Everybody good there again? Got the overlap? All right. So we're on the colors. So again, if you were to go through again, hey, we need you to replicate this like for like. There is a color palette in here, and in fact, it's the very last color palette, more than likely, in your version of Tableau. It's called Hue Circle. So if you select that, this is kind of the color arrangement. Your south is kind of your red, magenta kind of color. The central is kind of your light teal blue. East is that kind of vomit green, if you will. And the west is more of this purple bluish. So in here, and I'll put this up on Tableau Public, you'll be able to kind of look at it, download it again, reverse engineer it. But this really takes you through step by step on how to build it, exactly. You don't have to go through and do it exactly like it, but it's going to give you kind of a methodology on how to get to there. But that is the color palette that you want to use, hue circle. All right, so we're going to go in, but we need to make sure that we're on the circles and not the line. So we'll go in and edit the colors. So I clicked on the marks card, color marks card. I'm going to go all the way. I thought it was, wasn't it? Oh, here it is. All right, so I don't remember. What was central? That magenta, right?
Assign.
Well, assigned isn't necessarily going to give it the right color scheme. So there's a sign. It did. But what we need to do is now we need to
sort it,
essentially. And there's a bunch of different ways to sort. You can manually do this. That's what I like doing. So you can come into the legend over here and drag these up and down. The way it's supposed to go is south, central, east, and west. Or you can come in here and kind of do your sort and do a manual sort. Come up here, click. Again, it's what's going to work best for you and faster over time. For me, this is just way too slow. So again, I'm just kind of coming in here. So south, central, what is it? East and west. So we're good. All right. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 kind of knocked off. We need to show the lines. We've kind of done that already. All right. So we're making these min and max lines. I don't think you can really see them on the printout. Even on the website, it's hard to see, but they're kind of like dot matrix, dotted lines, very light, if you will. So let's kind of take a look and see what that looks like. All right, so I don't have a good visual for that, so we're going to actually just do it. All right, so show the lines. So we're going to come in here under format. We'll go under borders. So the row divider, the column divider. Again, I apologize. This is super hard to see, but essentially what we're doing is we're kind of giving it a background grid. Maybe I can use mine super dark. Is that working better for people that can actually see it, though? Give it a second to load here. How's everybody doing so far? So this is where, you know, again, kind of that nuance of formatting kind of comes in. It's, you know, we're done with the data part. You know, that was pretty easy. Now it's, you know, just getting the specifics of, okay, is the font the right size, is the right color. We'll need to create the, in just a moment, we're going to go back into the dashboard and we're going to actually create the title. We're going to add the filter and all that good stuff. And I think we're locked up. So let's kind of ad lib. For those of you that are in the worksheet of it, let's get the segment filter added so we can work on that. So in your dimensions. If you find segment, great. If you can't find it, go ahead and use a little search box and start typing segment. And I want you to drag that up into the filters shelf. Once you do that, go ahead and edit that filter. It may kind of pop up already, but we want to use select all or use all. All right. And the reason why we're doing that is as we create our dashboard, we're going to pull that filter in so we can give the end user the option to click or unclick certain things. But by default, we want everything selected. So it's just for now, go ahead and use all. All right, let's see. So the other thing we've already got, so we've created the data, we kind of did some semi-formatting. We're obviously not totally done with it yet, but I think we're far along to where you kind of get the point. So again, for those of you that are in the worksheet, you've added your segment to your filters. We're done at this point. So now we need to actually go into the dashboard, and we're gonna create essentially this last look and feel. How many of you kind of following along, or are you all rock stars and you're done at this point?
No, I'm lost.
I'm still following.
You're still lost? All right. And I apologize. We've got kind of, are we there yet? I think we're here. Wow.
Safe.
I know. Finally. All right. So let's go into the dashboard mode for now. You should have a sheet that is not called sheet one if you actually named it something. I hope all of you have something other than sheet one. So I'm gonna bring in mine, which is called regional sales. And again, I kind of see this legend off to the side. We're kind of close on things, but what we need to do is we need to give this a title. There's a couple ways to do this. We can drag in a text objects and launch this all the way to the top, or we can come up to dashboard and we can do a show title. And again, if your sheet name was named accordingly, this regional sales across the product hierarchy, you're good to go. Otherwise, go ahead and type that out. Now I believe the font is Tableau Bold and 18 point font, and then in this workbook I actually have the color that you want to use. I don't remember it offhand, but let's just wing it on any blue color for right now. And we want to actually center this. All right, starting to come together. What I can do, I can take this legend and kind of just drag it and drop it in place right underneath the title. We need to make this float across, kind of a single row. So the way to do that is come under your options, go to arrange items, and go to single row. And then I want to get rid of this title, and I want region up there, so I'm going to right-click and deselect show title. I cannot center this. Tableau doesn't have the ability right now to kind of come in, so I'm going to put like a little spacer in here. I'm going to take a blank item, and I'm going to kind of play with it. And that's not going to work without a little layout icon. So we're gonna drop a layout icon. I'm gonna bring in my region. I'll put this off to the side. Give it a little bit of padding. Pull this out a little bit more. All right, so we're good. The only thing I'm missing now is that filter. So on my main dashboard on the worksheet, I'm gonna go ahead and use the caret option. I'm going to click down. I'm going to go to filters. And we want that segment filter. And again, we just kind of want this pegged right between the title, right above the legend. Okay, that's looking good. Again, we don't have the ability to kind of center things, ideally. So we're gonna, again, use a layout container. I'm gonna pull this in. Drag this in it. I'm gonna take a blank to kind of give it a little bit of padding. How does that look? Looks like we have a title here. I don't need this title, so I'm gonna right click and choose hide title. Now I'm gonna launch this kind of in this full screen mode. So again, if you got your worksheet here, this looks pretty good. So those of you that are following along, is this kind of something that you ended up with, or anyone that's not even close? As long as you're kind of close, that's what we're aiming for. Again, this whole workbook will be published onto the Tableau Public. We'll communicate that out. You'll have a chance to download it. And again, it's got a whole walkthrough, so you can go through step by step on how that works.
How do you center that segment again?
So the way that I kind of did it is I built in a buffer. So I used a layout container. There's two different kinds here, like the horizontal and vertical.
Did you give that in?
So if you can see it here, it's really kind of this layout container. Once that was up there, I dragged a segment into it, and then I kind of gave it a little buffer with that blank object, and that's over here. So that kind of pushed it over towards the center a little bit. The same thing with the legend. Don't have the ability just to say, hey, nice center at this point yet, so.
How did you get to the filter to show?
Good question. So again, if you're on, you need to select this dashboard. You can also go up into the dashboard filters options, worksheet options. But if you click the little caret down here and go to filters, you should have segment there. You don't have it?
I'm going to say that's a slight line there.
So again,
it's really small. It's tiny. It's right up there.
High DPI, yeah. High resolution.
Yes,
oh,
they are.
That one.
There you go.
It's about 3 pixels across.
Show filter.
You can also right click and choose show filter. Again, there's a lot of different ways to do that.
I think you can actually right click on that.
And choose
too.
Show filter. All right, so we good? So again, the whole point of kind of the Workout Wednesday is to take an existing visualization, whatever it was, and try to replicate that. Again, paying close attention to, you know, are my numbers aligned? Is the colors on? Am I using the right chart type? Once you're done with this, there's instructions there to say, go ahead and publish this up to Twitter, tag it as a Workout Wednesday. We got the instructions for notifying the authors, kind of through that, but it's a social experiment. So if you're not on Twitter, get on Twitter. We're all on Twitter. This is how we help each other. But this is how you can get some good feedback. Hey, was I close? Did I get it right? You've got a global community kind of participating in this. A great way to get help, skill building along the way.
So.
All right, so that's that.
At least
their
shows are so
small.
It's
what
time
are we at?
Mm-hmm.
All right, so we're going to take a break. Let's do like a 5-10 minute break. So
okay,
when we come back, we're
going to
go full into Tableau's pre-release program, the beta program. If you're a customer and you want to participate with that, we'll walk around and we'll actually help you get signed up and start looking at the new features.
It's tiny, of course. But then you set this to like a buck there. Then Tableau, whatever it is.
The color? Like the legend?
So obviously,
yeah.
We may have to restart.
What do you mean?
It's the paint, the banding on the furniture.
That was one of the things I missed. So that's the formatting in the row banding. I'm going to show you where that is.
Oh, really? Where are you working at?
It's not a problem on computers that don't have really high resolutions, but they haven't fixed Tableau yet to work with that. Stop the video.